Oh my gosh, look at the size of these eggs. I mean, look at that egg right there. That is crazy. Hey, good morning, everybody. Welcome to the vlog. Today, we're gonna get back to feeding some snake. But before we do that, we actually have a few clutches of ball pythons to pull with Kelsey. Kelsey, what do we have up first?
Up first is a Cinna Winner bred to a Enchi Pin Banana.
Nice. Okay, the Cinna Winner is actually a Cinnamon, Pinstripe, and a Woma, and of course bred to an Enchi Pin Banana. Those are some pretty cool combinations. Oh, let's see what she's got going on. I don't like the fact that she's so shallow, but maybe she just has a really beautiful clutch of eggs under there. What do we got? Oh, I knew it didn't look good. I knew it was kind of, that's a terrible clutch. That's no way to start the day. It looks like we have one, two good eggs, maybe a third really super boob egg here, and then this guy over here. So definitely not a really good clutch. That sucks. That was a really exciting clutch for me, so I'm really bummed out about it. We only got a few possible babies out of that, but hey, that's the way it goes. We've been doing really well with ball pythons this year in fertility, so every now and then you're gonna have to have a bad clutch. Well, it can only get better from here. Well, I shouldn't say that. Can always get worse. What's the next clutch we have?
Next clutch is a yellow belly bred to a pastel ivory.
All right, and I love making white snakes. I mean, that's kind of what it's about. Oh, and she looks much better than this last one. Oh yeah, oh, I do see a slug egg. What is going on, man? Okay, it's not too bad. We definitely got a little slugger here, a little slugger there, but the rest of the clutch looks really good. But look, we got another boob egg over here, but this one isn't too bad. And by the way, I candled that one, and believe it or not, it's got a complete embryo in it. So I think it may hatch, but it'll hatch really small. But these guys actually look pretty good. We've got 2, 4, 6 good eggs, a couple slugs, not bad. Hey, we're trending in the right direction. We still have one clutch to pull. So hey, hopefully we'll continue to trend in that direction and we'll have a beautiful clutch of no slugs. We'll see how that goes. As for now, we're just gonna set these guys up in this box and we'll move on to the neck. And this is a clutch that I'm super excited about. This, of course, is an Enchi Het for Albino. I mean, albino Enchis are absolutely gorgeous, so hopefully she's got a good clutch in here. What does she got going on? Oh, right off the bat, we see one little slug, but that's okay. It's still only one slug, so it trended good. We had a bunch of slugs, then two slugs, now only one slug. It looks like we still have 2, 4, 6 eggs. So we still got 6 eggs out of that one. Not too terribly bad. We'll have Kelsey get these guys in the incubator box, and then we'll get on to feeding some snakes. Good job, Kelsey.
Thank you.
So it's been a little while since we've done a feeding video, and I figured it's about time to do it. So we have a lot of snakes to feed. Kelsey, you have the whole basement to feed along with Mary. What is it that you feed today, and what is it that Mary's gonna feed?
Well, normally I feed all the adult ball pythons. I also feed our carpet pythons and some of our Colombian boas. But today I'm helping Mary with like the other stuff, like the reticulated pythons and the crebos and our Brazilian boas.
You know, I think anytime someone gets into snakes, one of the things that's always exciting is feeding, right? I mean, I remember the first time I actually fed a snake, and this that feeling of like exhilaration. And again, I've always said, I don't like feeding rodents off. I definitely don't like feeding live rodents off because I don't get any pleasure in seeing anything die. But that being said, seeing snakes eat, there's just something really primordial about it. It's just amazing, it's exhilarating. So I know that if you keep snakes, you know exactly what I'm talking about. That one day a week, maybe that you feed your snake, you're looking forward to like, oh, tomorrow I get to feed that snake. Well, it's cool here because although we have a couple big feeds each week, the truth is we feed snakes almost every day. So we get that excitement all the time. And even after all these years of doing it, I still just get just as excited to see those snakes eat. Again, not because I like seeing rodents fed off, because I love rodents. Just the fact that I love that kind of satisfaction to know that that snake is healthy, because a healthy snake is a snake that eats. And we'll check in with Mary really quick. Mary, so you have to feed all the baby ball pythons right now too, right?
Yep. I try to make sure that all the cages are pretty clean for when they're eating. And then I defrost all the mice and then get them ready, and then I just go through and feed everyone.
Character. sure is a lot of rodents there. What do you got to feed today?
Heck yeah, it is. We're going to feed this row, all the snakes today, all the colubrids and the boas upstairs we're going to get fed off today. We just got our little small rat selection here, and we're going to move up to our mice, and then we've got a kind of a mixture of pinkies and our fuzzies, and just kind of according to the size of the snake, we just kind of look through and give them what they want.
I actually heard that Eric is a little bit bummed out about something that just happened recently. So what? There's some bad news? What happened?
I'm in a dark place. Okay.
What happened?
You know what? We, to top it all off, we started exercising recently. So we woke up extra early to go walk around the neighborhood this morning before work. Come outside, there's feathers scattered everywhere.
Oh, no, that's right. And you and Eric keeps chickens, and you have one really cool chicken. It didn't, nothing
yeah,
happened to that one, did it?
That was the chicken, the
what?
Trained one that I had, you know, like, you could call it over, and it would come inside, and yeah, it's really heartbreaking.
So what
it
happened?
Really sucks. You know what? The neighbor a couple houses down has some cats that kind of hang out there, and I think a cat grabbed it off the roost in the middle of the night.
Oh, so,
because, you know, chickens sleep at night, so they're very vulnerable, and something just came up and nabbed it.
So the chicken's gone. It's gone.
It's gone. Nothing but feathers. Feathers everywhere. No, I never found the chicken. I looked around. Hopefully one of my neighbor's kids don't go outside and there's a half-eaten chicken or something, you know, so I'll have to go kind of looking for it after.
But. Oh, my gosh. Eric, I am so sorry about that. He loved this chicken. It was such a cool little chicken. I had it in a vlog where it was eating mealworms and stuff like that. It was such a cool chicken, so I'm so sorry.
That's
man.
Okay, man. Cycle of life, I guess. It sucks, but, you know, what can you do?
Rest in peace, chicken.
Rest in peace, chicken.
Rest in
Ruby.
Peace, chicken. Rest in peace, Ruby.
Rest in peace, Ruby.
All right, I just fed off my last rat for the day, and I am done.
Have to take a quick break from work because we have to go pick up a trailer for my uncle because we're heading up north to my property that's up on Lake Superior, way up north. Some of the crew is actually coming up. We're doing some cleanup, going to be bringing some stuff down. So we have to go and get this trailer, and then we come back and get more snake work done. All right, so we're at our uncle's place. This is the trailer we're going to be taking up north. Only problem is that we don't have a key to undo the hitch so that we can hitch it up. So I don't know where my uncle is, so we've got to find a key so we could take this bugger up. But we have to go up 6 hours straight up north to Lake Superior, towing this little beast here. It's not gonna be fun, especially going over that big Mackinac Bridge. You guys know I hate bridges, so it's not gonna be a fun time, but hey, it's gonna be great once we get up there. Well, as luck has it, no key to undo the thing, so we just wasted a half hour driving here, and now we're gonna have to come back later because my uncle's not around. He didn't leave a key for us, but what can you do? I guess just adds a little wrinkle to our day. Oh, well, that didn't work out too well, but I guess we're back to snake work and checking out some eggs. Take a look at this girl here. She definitely looks like she laid a big clutch of eggs. Sometimes those females just look like they took a lot out of them. I mean, look at how thin she looks, which just tells me that she really put a lot of energy into egg production. So let's take a look and see what she's got. Oh my gosh, look at the size of these eggs. I mean, look at that egg right there. That is crazy. No wonder why she looks so skinny. The good news is with colubrids is you feed them a couple times, they just pop right back out. But she didn't have a big clutch, just really big eggs. Looks like she's got 1, 2, 3, 4 eggs then. And of course, that's a Mexican Black King. That's pretty awesome. This is our first albino Nelson's clutch of the year, so I'm excited to see how these guys are doing. And you start to see a theme, like with fertility and stuff like that. If a group is doing really well, it usually plays through or vice versa. So let's see what we have here. Oh yeah, I like the looks of this. Oh my gosh, look at that beautiful clutch of eggs. Oh mama, you did so good. Way to go. Take a look at those right there. There's 2, 4, 6, 8 good eggs. That's a good sign. Again, like I said, when a female lays a good clutch, typically throughout the entire colony, you'll start to get good eggs. When they start to see slugs, sometimes that means a bunch of males are bad. So that was a really good way to start the albino Nelson's year. Looks like Phoebe is trying to help me. Let's go ahead and move on. The next one is an apricot club and milk snake. Okay, she's out of her box. As you can see right here, she looks fine. A Again, she looks pretty deflated, which means she put a lot of energy into egg production, but she looks completely good. So let's take a look. Oh yeah, ooh, doggy, that's another beautiful clutch. That's 2, 4, 6, 8, 9 good eggs. That is really good. Remember I had told you that Pueblos typically lay in between 6 and 10 eggs. So a 9 egg clutch is definitely on the high side of production there. And these are perfect size eggs. Look at how pearly white they are. So we'll get those in the incubator box and we'll keep on moving on. Next up is a het albino scaleless corn snake. And for whatever reason, this group typically seems to do a little better than some of our other het scaleless. So let's see what we've got going on here. Oh, that isn't exactly the greatest of clutch right there for sure. Looks like 1, 2, 3, 4 good eggs and 5, 6 bad eggs. So 4 and 6. So just when I said this group does good, I get bad eggs. But hey, we have a couple more clutches to go. So hopefully I'll redeem myself. Okay, another het albino scaleless. Let's see if this one is a little better than that last clutch, because that was a little bit disappointing. But you know, I want you guys to understand that I don't get upset about it or anything like that. That's just part of breeding. And I want to take you guys on the good, the bad, the ugly. I want to show you the good triumphs of great clutches, and I want to show you the sad parts when we don't have a good clutch. I'm grateful for everything we get. So this clutch definitely looks much, much better. Again, this is a het albino scaleless corn snake. And this mama looks pretty good. She looks nice and healthy too, so that's really good. Looks like she rebounded really well from that, which means she should be in good shape for a second clutch. But let's go ahead and see what she has here. Looks like we have 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 good eggs and 2 slugs. So that is definitely much better fertility-wise. And that's typically the example of the het albino clutch. We also have creamsicle scaleless that seem to do really well. And as a matter of fact, we have a clutch of these right here. So that's the next clutch I'm gonna pull. And let's go ahead and move on to this clutch. Let's see if I have it right and it's a good clutch. Looks like it's pretty good. What do we got? Oh yeah, look at that. Ooh, doggy, that is a beautiful clutch. Mama, you did so good. And you can really see with these het creamsicle how different they look. And that's because there's a little bit of emery rat influence in it. And that's typically why the scaleless corn snakes have a little bit lower count, is because there's actually emery rat in the scaleless project. So let's go ahead and see. Look at how big these eggs are. Holy moly, those things are huge, and that's a lot of eggs. That is a beautiful clutch. That's 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 17. I tell you, that is absolutely the largest clutch of scaleless I've ever had in all the years I've been breeding them. So that is absolutely a great way to end the collection of eggs today. All right, so snake work done. I'm gonna go back to my uncle's and hopefully I'll find a key and be able to hook this trailer up. All right, so back at my uncle's, success. We have the trailer hitch up. We've got everything set and ready to go. So we're gonna be up super early in the morning. I'm gonna head over to the shop really quick just to check on the animals and then head up north. It's gonna be a really cool, fun day and a half kind of adventure, kind of hanging out a little bit. I'm so glad the crew is going to come. It's going to be absolutely amazing. As for now, I'm going to shut the vlog down, get on home, and get my last things done for the night. Thank you guys, as always, for joining me. You guys mean the world to me, and I love you so much. Have an absolutely amazing day. Do me a couple favors, as always. Hit that like button, turn those post notifications on, make sure to make a comment, and always be kind to someone, and I promise I'm going to see you guys bright and early tomorrow.